Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. I have always loved the idea that a photograph is a memory frozen in time. Could we do the same for proteins? Why proteins? Well, the majority of available drugs have protein molecules as their targets. Proteins are large, complex molecules that play critical roles in the body. They do most of the work in cells and are required for structure, function, and regulation of the body's tissues and organs. Moreover, proteins rarely act alone. They interact with one another to regulate a variety of cellular functions. In this episode of Behind the Science, let's take a trip to the lab at the University of Texas to see how they're freezing time when it comes to protein. Hi, Sheena.
Good day, Jen.
Thank you for hosting Behind the Science. What a beautiful facility you have here.
Thanks.
So tell me a little bit more about what you do in your lab.
Well, in my lab, we work on proteins and their complexes, and we use something that's called the hybrid structural approach. So we figure out what they look like and how they work using a variety of techniques at the highest resolution possible. So we do things like X-ray crystallography and mass spectrometry.
So it doesn't sound like you're a native Texan.
No, I'm not. But as they say in Texas, I got here as fast as I could.
Well, with that said, let's go as fast as we can to meet the students in your lab.
Great. Hi, Nushin.
Oh, hi.
Jen, this is Nushin.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Nushin. Thanks for having me.
Nice to meet you.
She's a PhD student in the lab, and she's been doing some X-ray crystallography. I'm going to leave you two together to talk, you know, experiments while I go and write some grants.
All right. Thank you so much. So, Nushin, I hear that you're doing some really cool work freezing proteins in time.
Well, hold on there, Jen. What we're doing is called protein crystallography. We need to know the structure of our protein, and all we want to have a high-resolution picture of a protein or protein complex that we work with.
So what's the first step of that process?
Well, first we need to have a lot of protein, highly pure, and that's why we begin with protein purification. There's actually this little room back there that we start purifying. I can show you if you want.
Yeah, let's go take a look. So tell me a little bit more about what's going on in this lab.
Well, Jen, I'm growing 6 liters of bacteria right here that's expressing my protein of interest, which is actually a human protein.
Wow, so how do you distinguish from your human protein from the millions of bacterial proteins in that mix?
Well, it's actually thousands, but still really challenging. I can show you through the whiteboard.
Let's take a look.
The proteins we work on are recombinant proteins, which means we insert a human gene into bacteria. The bacteria makes the protein and then we purify it using chromatography. We use different types of chromatography based on the properties of the protein. We can separate them based on charge, size, or artificial tags. After all these purification steps, we hopefully obtain very pure protein, which can be used for crystallization trials.
So it sounds pretty straightforward, but how do we get from here to a crystal?
Well, that's going to be our next step. Follow me. We set up high concentrated protein in crystallization plates. We mix small volumes of protein with small volumes of a particular condition in a reservoir. We test so many different conditions to maximize the chance of getting a hit in at least one of the drops. There are a variety of ways to set up the trays, such as hanging drop and sitting drop, but they all follow the same principle of vapor diffusion. Through this process, the concentration of the protein increases in the drop as it's equilibrating with the condition in the reservoir. Crystal growth will occur and we go from proteins moving freely in solution to hopefully proteins stacked perfectly in a crystal lattice, being so-called frozen in time.
So is this a crystal time capsule?
Well, let me show you. It's actually a frozen time capsule. So we set up all these hundreds of different protein conditions to maximize our chance of getting a protein crystal because it's pretty unpredictable.
These are a lot of crystallization trials.
Well, yeah, from here we just cross our finger and hope we get a crystal.
Cross our fingers. The availability of atomic resolution structures provides a deep and unique understanding of protein function and helps to unravel the inner workings of the living cell. One of the biggest motivations behind crystallography is to target key proteins with appropriate drugs that can hopefully one day cure diseases. To learn more about the work the Darcy Lab is doing, check out the link below. Join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.